Welcome to Bani Abroad. In this video, I will reveal it all about my part-time jobs, whether it be the time that it took me to land one or the different stores that I worked at, and also about the freebies or the discounts that I had, what were the positions that I held, and what was the distance that it took me to commute from my place to the job, and also some interesting anecdotes. So make sure that you stick till the end if you want to hear the juicy stuff. So if you're new to this channel, then I make content on studying and settling abroad that will give you an edge. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button right now. So let's start from the very beginning. The first job that I had here in Canada, the part-time job, was at Tim Hortons. Yes, the very famous Tim Hortons of Canada. And I'll tell you the entire process, the interview, and also how many months did it take me to land one. Starting from the beginning, I started applying in November. Yes, that was one mistake that you should not be making. As soon as you land here in August or September, grab a job. That's the best chance to land one. And the reason that I did not start applying in September was that I did not have a place yet. I was living at my father's friend's place and I did not know where I'll eventually live, so I thought that anyway I have to move, so I'll find a job near that area. So that's why it got delayed. So when I shifted here in the Cinewoyen, this is the Cinewoyen room, that's the York University graduate housing, then I was just doing freelancing, so I did not look for a job then. And I eventually started looking for a job in November, and I got my Tim Hortons job in January. So yes, it took me around 1.5-2 months to land that. And this is the mistake that you should not make. Start applying in August or September, the moment you land here. One thing that you can do is, when you are not sure about where you live, you can start searching jobs in and around your campus, because anyway you will be going to the campus, so you can just extend your stay there and work. And the other thing that you can do is that, do not limit your search. I limited my search to just the on-campus job. I was applying on Indeed, no doubt. I was applying on Indeed for jobs that were not on campus, but Indeed has a pretty low response rate. And the resume that I dropped off, I think I just dropped in and around York University. And the other main reason why it took me so long to get a part-time job, because November and December is a pretty dull season here, because all the hiring stops and people are no longer looking for employees to fill their stores. Anyway, they are going to shut down the stores, and the thing here in Canada is that people value their personal time a lot. So if it's Christmas, if it's New Year in India, we see that the shops are open till late because they know that people will be shopping more, even on Diwali. But here, when it's a festival, you will find almost nothing open. Employers do not look for people during this season and they wait for January to fill in the vacant positions. That's what I heard from everyone when I was going and applying, and they told me that they're no longer hiring and you can come back in January. And January, I'll tell you, something magical happened. So a lot of people told me that when the campus reopens, that was in January, go then, because that's also when the second phase of hiring happens. And I did follow that advice and I did get a job on the second day. So the first day that the campus opened, I went, I dropped in my resume, and the second day I got the call from Tim Hortons and they asked me to come for an interview right the next day. So I went, I gave the interview, and I was selected on spot. That's not an achievement. I mean, they just want a person who can work. It's not that you have to be this qualified or that qualified. It was pretty easy. They just told me about the role and how would it be and would I be comfortable doing it, and I responded, and then they said that you can come with the documents tomorrow and we'll get you started. So that was the process about getting that Tim Hortons job. And one other mistake that I think I made, if I had not made that, I wouldn't say that it was a mistake. It was a personal decision. I wouldn't call that a mistake. So a lot of people told me, fill in your resume with previous experience of a cashier or barista, but I did not have any. And obviously there's some truth to it, because the employer would prefer a person who already has cashier experience if it's, suppose, the job of a cashier, or a barista experience if it's the barista job. But I don't know, I did not write that stuff. I just wrote about my education, qualifications, the internships, like what's the proper resume. I've even heard that people here just copy paste the resume of someone else, and maybe they just change the school, but the work experience section, they just copy paste that and they get the job. So I think it just boils down to you regarding this point, if you want to bluff or not. But I'm just telling you that's what people do so that you have the holistic picture and you can use your options wisely. But with this resume also, it had no cashier experience, it had no other relevant experience which is needed in these part-time jobs. But still I got it, so I'm grateful for that. But it did take me longer, and you come across this video, just keep trying, you will eventually land one. Don't lose hope, you will get a job. And also I'll tell you a little tips and tricks that I've learned now that you can use to increase your probability and also to reduce the time it takes to land the job. Okay, so now let's talk about the experience. So I had a job that was a mix of a barista and a cashier. So you stand at the cash and you deal with the customers and then also make coffee or and whatever drinks side by side. So it's pretty hectic. So one thing was that our Tim Hortons did not have that elaborate menu. It was just limited to drinks, donuts and muffins. So that was it. So I got to know how to make cappuccino, how to make frappe. Oh, it's double double. So double double here is 2 shots of cream and 2 shots of sugar. So I learned the lingo, and I'll tell you about the bad part now. It was damn hectic. And when I say this, I'm not kidding. I did not have a single second to catch my breath. It was the customer coming in, making the coffee, taking the cash, and on to the next customer. There was not a single moment where I could be, okay, I'm waiting for the next customer, because the next customer was always there. Tim Hortons is that popular in Canada. And most of the days I had my morning shift, so that was from 8 to 2, and those were the busiest hours. And the line there, it went beyond the door. Some of the times my colleagues would say that when I was new, "Bhai, fast, fast, you have to work fast." And I was like, oh God, how can I go faster than this? But then eventually I got the hang of it and I tried my best. I took it as a challenge that I have to work faster, if that was even possible. So this was about the experience. Now let's talk about after working hours. So when I used to come home, there was no commute. That was the best part. It was just right on campus. It just took me 10 minutes on foot to reach Tim Hortons. So I would just, like, suppose my shift is at 8, I would get ready and leave my home at 7:50, and I was there on time. So that was the best part. And talking about when I came home after completing my shift, I was so exhausted. Initially, I used to sleep 2-3 hours just to relax so that I can work, so that I can work on my assignments and I can study for my exams. Gradually, of course, things started to get better and I was acclimatized to the pace. So this was about Tim Hortons. And one thing that I would say, that if you are getting a fast food restaurant job versus any other job, I'm not talking about the factory jobs or the warehouse jobs, but in retail, prefer those. Don't go for the fast food joints because they are going to be hectic. But if you are tempted by the free food that you will get, then that's the other thing. Thing was that our Tim Hortons wasn't just the Tim Hortons. It was under Aramark. So Aramark is a company here and it deals with a lot of stores. So we had a lot of cuisines there and we could choose any one. There were 2 kind of breaks. One was half an hour and the other one was 10 minute break. In the 10 minute break, we could get any beverage or a muffin. And in the half an hour break, which was the best for me, so we could get anything from the nearby stores that were there because they were under the same company. And my favorite go-to meal there was the burger because they made a healthy one and I used to love that. And also there used to be pasta, pizza. You could basically have anything. And I really enjoyed that part, and that was like, I used to look forward to that, just to eat that burger. And if you have any other questions about Tim Hortons, the comment box is right there. Now coming to my second job, so I would say that I have in total 3 different type of part-time jobs, so stick till the end to know about those as well. So the second job, I would tell you the story why I had to go to the second job, because my part-time job was on campus. I earlier thought that it was a blessing. My accommodation was on campus, my part-time job was on campus. But then what happened? The pandemic engulfed all of us. Since the campus closed, there was no one coming there at Tim Hortons and they had to eventually shut it down. We all got laid off, and since I was not eligible for SERP, I did not have the free cash flowing in. So I had to make sure that I land another part-time job. But then I was paranoid. Initially, I was really paranoid. I did not step out of my house. I just used to go on walks with my friend just to get out of the house and keep myself sane. So eventually, I started applying. So the second time was the same for me. It was a struggle, and I was not one of those lucky ones who could get a job in one single day. This time, my friend also decided that she'd also start working part-time. So we both went hunting for jobs. This time, we did not limit our search because that would not have been possible. Everything was shut down on campus. So we went to downtown, dropped our resume there, and then we went to One Mills. One Mills is a mall here. One thing I would like to tell you is, you should keep in mind is that Canadians here are never blunt. When you will go and drop your resume and talk to them, it would appear as if they love you and they are going to take you, and there's no one else that they would ever take if you are applying for that position. But after a few days, nothing happens. So this time the dull season was not the case. The case was the pandemic, and that slowed down things for us. But we never lost hope. We kept applying, and there was this one time we realized that now it's high time that we are going to graduate. We should start applying for full-time jobs, and all our remaining time was invested in going out, dropping resume, applying on Indeed. That did take a toll on us, and we were like, maybe no one would have ever gone through this strenuous process of applying to a part-time job, which we have. There were no people in the stores. No one wanted to hire extra people just to pay them when they are not even having the profit. But then we kept applying. So I told you that we went to One Mills, right? So there we met a person and we interviewed, and everything was fine, and the person was impressed. This was the intuition that we knew that we were going to get this job, both of us. We both interviewed together. But towards the end of the interview, he asked us about our working hours. So we said 20 because we were still on study permit. And then came the breaking news, which was that he just needed people who were able to work for 40 hours, and there was no way that we could work for 40 hours. So then what we did was that after we completed our degree, we did apply for our work permit, and I have done a 1-year degree. So that's a bit risky because you only get 1 year afterwards. Like holistically, you get 1 year plus the processing time, which is more because of COVID, and that's why we thought that anyway we would get that buffer time so we can apply. So we did apply for our work permit, and then we called that person because he already told us that whenever you would be eligible for 40 hours, I'll hire you that very day, so just call me. So we applied and we called him. He told us that he no longer works there, and we were like, oh my god. But he was so nice, so he referred us to one of the other branches. So the store is Toys R Us. Toys R Us has various branches all over Canada. So we went there, we interviewed there, and then this question came: don't you think you're overqualified for this job? And I was like, oh damn, maybe he wouldn't hire me because of this. Because he was apprehensive that, because obviously I would be looking for full-time corporate roles. He agreed, and that was a sigh of relief, because if I didn't start working then, I would have to call my parents and ask for money, which I did not want to. I had exhausted my GIC and my savings from my previous job. So that was it. On the brink, like when my account balance was going to get nil, I got that job. So I'm thankful for that. Oh, I forgot to tell you about my second job. So the second job was not Toys R Us. The second job was at Water Bagel, and that was only for 2 days. And the story is that I got the job late and I started working, and then I had my exams back to back, and then our result came out, and as soon as your grades get released, you can't work part time. Even though I know that you are on your study permit and you would have your SIN number and everything, but you can't work legally if your grades are out. So again, I had to drop that job. That was a fast food job, and it was COVID, so it was not that hectic. And resuming to my third job, which I'm currently doing, so that is Toys R Us. And my experience have been lovely there. It's not that hectic. So because I'm used to the tougher part, I find it easy now. The only sad part here is that I have to stand. So I do get tired, my feet get tired. Other than that, everything is amazing. The people there are amazing. The environment, the vibe, the store is amazing. And also it's not that hectic as I mentioned. And then there are interesting conversations that happen with people. And there are parents coming to buy gifts for the children. Some of the times they do also accompany children, so it's really pleasant because it's not that, okay, go grab your coffee, go, there's next person in line. So you actually get the chance to make small talk and ask the person about how they are doing. So I've had amazing conversations and amazing customers. Like the other day, there was this guy who had kids. He was buying something for his kids, and I asked him, how's his experience been with kids? And he said that, oh, they are my two favorite human beings on the entire earth, and I love being a dad. So conversations like these, and then there are parents who teach their kids the value of money. So there are little girls, and their mom's like, okay, buy this with your own money. So they'll get their little cute purses and take the money out and give it to me. So that's very endearing, and I get to see a lot of new things, and the people there are also really supportive, so that's good. And the discount we get there is a 15% employee discount. This entire experience, I'm talking about cashier, I'm not a floor associate, I'm not in the merchandising team, so those things I would think would be more hectic because you have to keep walking the entire day. So yeah, I told you that I would reveal it all. So these were the positions and this was my experience. So I feel that there are things that you can learn from this video. One thing is that if you're coming for fall intake, apply right then. Even for Jan intake, like apply in Jan itself. The other thing is that don't limit your search. You can find it in a radius of where the commute would be half an hour or even 1 hour, so that is fine. The third thing is that if you wouldn't want to be in a very fast-paced environment, which is physically exhausting, and also apart from the experience, if you want some information on tips and tricks on how to get a part-time job faster, then I have made a video and the link is there, and also in the description box you can watch that. And there's this one thing that would 10x your chances, yes, not even double, triple, 10x your chances, or even make it sure shot that you will get the job, is to get a referral. So in part-time jobs, what happens is that when you drop the resume, the manager might not be there, and there might be just the employees working there. Maybe they wouldn't pass your resume off to the manager, or even if they do, they would have preference, because at most of all the places there's this referral policy that if they refer someone and they get onboarded, they'll get a referral bonus. And also because of friendship, so if they have a friend who needs a part-time job, they'll directly tell to the manager and pass off their resume. What this will do is that the manager will know that this person would be accountable, and that person is not a complete stranger. This person knows and vouches for that person. So 99% of the time, that friend will get a job and not you. So make sure that you are that friend and not any random stranger. So if you have any friends working here, any relatives, make sure that you tap into their network. I did not have anyone here to help me out, so I could not avail that option. But if you have friends who are already here, then it would be a lot easier for you to get a job. So make sure that you tap into that. So this was it, and if you liked watching the video, then make sure that you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also press that bell icon.